I remember when I first got involved with RepresentUs, there were some staggering numbers that were thrown out that made this very simple to understand. So gerrymandering is really affects how we vote, because we have representatives based on what district we're in. So we have a representative that represents our district. And what gerrymandering is it's determining or drawing the lines of the district. But what you can do, especially now with the information that's available from the census, is you can choose, if you're in power, what that district looks like and therefore manipulate the outcome. So I remember a very scary number was something like 87% of districts are uncompetitive in terms of how they're drawn. So it doesn't matter how you vote in 87% of districts, it's predetermined. And that's because of things like gerrymandering. What it does is it disempowers voters. Mm-hmm. So you saw in Atlanta, actually, there were certain regions that were majority Black, but then you would have a conservative suburb included. And I guess a simple way to put it would be drown out a vote. Mm-hmm. That's not a nice way to say it, but that's what happens. It's how can you make certain votes not matter by surrounding it with another political affiliation.
Right.
So what is crucial now is passing the For the People Act, because it addresses things like gerrymandering and as you mentioned, dark money. Right. I remember another number was that 50% of the time, someone who's working in Congress or representatives are in office, 50% of the time, they're raising money for the next election cycle.
Wow.
So that is not an efficient use of time. I wouldn't want to pay someone who half the time they're in office is trying to get ready for the next job.
Right.
And what that means is that our representatives are beholden to big donors because they need the money to win elections. And what if we could change that is the question. What if we could limit the impact of big donations and special interests and instead have our representatives represent us? The people, that's what they're there for. It's in the Constitution, just saying. Right.
You would think that's what, I mean, we're in a democracy, right? So hopefully that would be one of their job priorities. And I think like it's also so important because this happens every 10 years. So the next time we get a chance like this for redistricting and gerrymandering, as you explained it to happen, it's going to be 10 years from now, which is a long time to live under a system we might not like or doesn't hear all of our voices equally. So
we were joking earlier, like if you look back 10 years ago, I mean, what, 2011?
Right. People just started.
Oh my God. Yeah, exactly. And I think I had the first brick iPhone. I like that as a metric because you're like, okay, all right. Wow. That was a long time ago. Was Instagram even around 10 years ago? I'm not sure.
Maybe. It might have been like a year before.
That's 10. I mean,
that's a long time.
You think what happens for the next 10 years if we don't address this stuff, the amount of time, the amount of things that can happen if our voices aren't included. Mm-hmm. To me, climate change, these are issues I care about, are on the table. Mm-hmm. And I want a voice. I want my voice to be part of that.
So Max, what can we do? Like what can we all do to help and take action?
Yeah, so it's not that hard, actually. I think that's when we hear these big political words like gerrymandering and voting rights, go, well, how as a single person, what can I do to help? This seems too big. And the truth is, no. Collective action is really important, but collective action starts with you. And what you can do is you can have a conversation with a family member and a friend about this. But the reason why we're here is because I love RepresentUs, and they already made up a game plan. They have the actions for you. It's at represent.us/max. That sounds pretty simple. And what it is it's coming together. Sometimes it sounds like a big pain in the, but if you pick up the phone and you call your local elected official and just say, hey, I really care about the For the People Act. And as a voter in your blah, 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 and you have a conversation, there's scripts online for you. It's not hard. And it makes all the difference in the world. Mm-hmm. If you can get 2 friends, 5 friends, maybe where you just agree, hey, I'm going to hold you accountable. Pick up the phone, call your local person, deliver the message, and you keep doing that. Again, I'm going to throw, I love numbers.
Yeah.
There's a number I believe it's 3.5% is the magic number. If 3.5% of a population comes together, they can pass anything. That's wow. You look back across history, the civil rights movement, gay marriage, equality, all of that starts once you hit the 3.5% threshold, it becomes federal. So if, wow. if we can get a small group of people who are really passionate, apply pressure, take very simple actions like go to represent.us/max, follow the instructions, we can change this.
3.5%, that's such a small number. It's like still single digit. So sounds like something we can definitely do, even just us young people or millennials and Gen Z, if we get enough mass momentum going. So yeah, good numbers to be encouraged by. And like Max said, guys, go to represent.us/max and get involved. Let's do this.